That's a stretch. So until you get to the round of 32, So at the round of 32, they will very likely go up against Team Element, which, if you've been following the European scene lately, Element has been doing very well. The problem is, I don't know if they've been doing well enough to really be considered as a team that can take down Team Secret. I mean, that's really their first big challenge besides maybe Team Chappie, I think. So Secret, a pretty comfortable position for the next couple of hours, if not longer. But we're going to follow them and kind of see how they play, because you never know. What if the upset happens? We want to have somebody here to cast it. So we'll see where it goes. Now, the... Holy cow, Jesus Christ, Puppy. Puppy gets a Beastmaster, a Rubick, and an Alchemist. So three heroes that are going to be very difficult for the Dire to deal with here. Mirana, Vengeful Spirit, and Invoker. Last game we saw, Arteezy ran the Invoker and completely obliterated the Tinker in the mid position. Now Alchemist is going to run the Invoker and obliterate probably the mid position. I just don't know how you come back and win this. I mean, you really got to try a strategy out. I think to defeat Secret in the open qualifiers, in these best of ones, a cheese or avoidance is the best way to do it. What we're seeing from Puppy's drafts is he wants to make sure that the avoidance doesn't happen, the late game isn't allowed to get out of control, and the cheese is prevented. And Beastmaster and Rubick both provide that. Rubick has the ability to steal whatever your stupid cheese idea is. Beastmaster and Alchemist can control waves and split pushes. Ember Earth Spirit will allow hard rotations. So really, now your avoidance game is sort of off the mark. A Blink Rubick and a Boulder Earth Spirit mean the avoidance game is dead for all intents and purposes. Invoker, Venge, and Mirana bring some combos to the game, but still not really effective enough. That's interestingly enough, Sniper is banned out here. Again, the first two bans used by Puppy. And this says a lot, I think, about his perspective of the current meta, is he's not banning out heroes who you would traditionally see him ban out during a pro game ban phase. He's banning invisible heroes. He's banning heroes that are atypical, that you could build some unique strategies around. He doesn't want to deal with you having vision. He wants to take that away, and that's what he's doing, and that's why the Ricky and the Bounty are the first ones to come off the board in the last two games. He has no desire to deal with those invisibility heroes, and I think that that's the right choice. Now, on the opposite side, Team Secret, they banned the Darkseer, and they banned the Elder Titan. Now, the Elder Titan was a 100% respect ban because these guys had a chance to watch the end of Puppy's last game. Now, Puppy played the Elder Titan better than I think I've seen the ET played in a very long time. It was super effective and very well done. And the opposing team is just not willing to deal with that. So they go ahead and knock it out. The problem is that just opens up the Earth Spirit to be used even more effectively, I think, by Puppy. He likes to use those stun heroes, likes to be very aggressive, and should be pretty good on it. All right, so now you're sitting there thinking, what do I run as a chance to try and beat you? They pick up the Magnus, and this draft is starting to feel less like a strategic draft and more like, let's just play our best heroes and hope that we can beat these guys. I don't know if that's the strategy to use when you're going up against Team Secret, but it seems like what they're going to go with. Toppy's Jr. sounding off. Team ban.
Seconds remaining.
Also worth mentioning that the Drow was run by Arteezy in the last game and was another impossible to stop hero for the opposing team. So respect bans on both counts there.
You're gonna see, sorry.
10 seconds remaining.
Slark banned out by Puppy, and once again, they try to get rid of these heroes that have comeback potential. They know that they can win the early game. They know, and this is the thing. You know, Secret knows that their laning is superior in every way to almost every team that they come up against outside of the top maybe 15 teams in the world. Their mechanics and their laning and their rotations are incredible. What that means is that you're going to have a good start.
10 seconds remaining.
Allowing that to happen, allowing that to put to to not have a comeback, and that's in the sense of like a Slark or a hard farming late gamer who can make a bounce back after a bad laning phase is something you don't want to allow, and that's what they're not going to pass through here. Now, Juggernaut gets picked up. I'm curious about this. He is a good hero. The problem is there's a lot of stun and a lot of trouble for him on the side of Team Secret. You're going to have summonables to ruin his jumps. They're not going to care about his spin. They have a ton of physical damage. And Juggernaut, I think, is a good pick in terms of carry right now, and he's got some farm potential, but you can't out-farm Team Secret. They're going to be in your jungle. I guarantee that the second that that Juggernaut thinks he can try to jungle, you're going to have a Rubick, you're going to have an Earth Spirit, you're going to have a Slardar jammed so far up your backside, you're not going to have a chance to even try to get a Battle Fury, which I think this Jug is going to go for. I'd rather see him go for a Sans Yasha, maybe even an Ags build for early to mid functionality, but he's going to go Battle Fury. He's going to get there at 27 minutes, and it's going to be way too late. That's my prediction right now. Mark it down. Somebody put it in chat. Chat's not going very fast, so we'll be able to see it. 27-minute Battle Fury, bare minimum. Maybe 32, but 27 to 32, that's my prediction for that job. Or not to finish up a Battle Fury.
Prepare for battle.
Ah, that explains a lot.
Seconds to battle.
All right, Puppy's gonna head down towards the bottom lane with the group. Let's do some quick introductions. This may be the only time that the Dire gets to be introduced to the entire universe. Let's do it real quick, guys. Playing for the Dire side, it's gonna be Ascario playing the Vengeful Spirit. Merz is gonna be playing that Invoker. We're gonna have Scream on the Magnus. Juggernaut will be played by none other than Cat Dancer. And last but not least, Yo, gonna be bringing home on the Mirana. For Team Secret, it's gonna be Poppy playing the Earth Spirit. Eternal Envy carrying on the Slark. We're gonna have Bulba on the Beastmaster. Pilot Eye on the Rubick. And Arteezy taking the lead with the Alchemist. And I expect that to be a very difficult mid lane for Merz to deal with here. Merz and him going to be going head to head. They've got the Mirana looking to get a gank, and that's what they want to do, is try to pick off the courier early on. The question is, can they do it? Bulba's not that far out of range to maybe rotate in that direction and catch a little something. Nobody in the offlane right now. There's the roll. Scream wasn't expecting it. We'll secure them to the tower. So a pretty nice play by Scream, actually. And maybe a little bit of a bold play by Secret. They brought everyone down to the bottom lane to try and get a pickoff. Arteezy head-to-head with Merz, going back and forth. Yo is going to be rotating around. He's got the mana already running. Wants to try and throw an arrow in here to try and pick off Arteezy potentially. The courier went to bottom lane instead of mid. So Yo now just wasting time. On the high ground. Got enough for one arrow attempt. Catches Arteezy. Merz, who has the Sunstrike and the Forge Spirits, could do some damage to him, but will it be enough? There's the arrow. It's not even going to get a creep. It's just going to pass right through. Pinged out by Arteezy, says team is here. Merz and Yo looking to go around and around. Pilot Eye gonna keep the farm away from Scream. Skeezy pushing the mid lane up. Last hit so far for the Juggernaut, pretty decent, but there's the first blood. We got there a little bit late. I didn't expect them to make that move, but it was a lift, a roll, and a crush. And that was just a really strong initiation and follow-up by the guys here. Now Murr's very low, Arteezy forcing him backwards, and Murr's drops all the way down to 92 health, has to use a fairy, I'm sorry, a salve, and we'll try to get himself back into this. I'll go back to the bottom where Eternal Envy and Scream are going head-to-head here. Scream back from an unfortunate gank that cost him his life not long ago. Still, no one on the top lane. They have literally said, we trust that Cat Dancer cannot get farm better than our Beastmaster can pick it up in the jungle. Pilot Eye comes forward, harassing Scream. They're going to pick up, roll, arrow to save. Will it be enough? Good spear backwards. Eternal Envy caught, but Scream will very likely go down. Envy's gonna back away. Scream thought about chasing, but missed with the shockwave. Envy goes down, but he's killed by a neutral creep. Nicely played. Scream ultimately escapes with 60 health, but Envy knew that his time would potentially come to an end, so he just lets himself die. Arteezy and Murr's head-to-head in the front room. Still free farm for the Juggernaut up top. He's 22 and 11, so he's being relatively effective up here as he's left alone. Arteezy at 18 right now, 2 points into his Grievous Greed. 21-0 for the Beastmaster. Gold lead is strongly in Radiant's side, 1500 XP about the same. Murr's taking a lot of damage. Arteezy doesn't have any stuns, so Murr's not worried about it at the moment. And again, he'll pop the salve. So Murr's going through an awful lot of regeneration to stay in lane here.
Double damage.
Arteezy will head towards the top rune to try and get it. It's not going to happen. So Morana does throw the arrow to make sure that she can secure the rune. It's a bounty, which stinks for Arteezy. He's not going to get a chance to go ahead and pick that up. And that is relatively unfortunate for him. Meanwhile, on the top, Juggernaut's actually started to push into the tower because he's got so much space. He's finished up his phase boots. He's doing well in terms of farm. The problem is 1, 2, 3, go to the Radiant. Here comes Puppy and Pilot Eye rotating around the outside. Murr's is in some serious trouble here if they can close the gap. Murr's will fall backwards. Now he comes forward. This is going to be the time to roll once those creeps go under tower. Here comes Arteezy, nice body blocks. He wants to try to engage in front of the tower rather than behind it, but he does throw the acid spray a little high up. That may deter Murr's from being in a ganked position. Puppy comes forward, and now Murr's will see him. Pings him out, says they're here. And the gank goes downhill. Had that acid spray been held for just a second longer, I think that might have been enough space for Puppy to come in and get the kick. Ascario is going to back away, pulls the creep camp. That may cause some trouble for Juggernaut, who is going to be sort of exposed here now. Touch the computer, buddy. It might fall over. Careful, okay? Alright, we're back online. Game underway. Dancer getting pinged. They're saying, let's do something here. Oh no, rotation coming from Puppy as well. This is the end. They gave him free farm and they... Puppy giveth and Puppy taketh away in terms of allowances here. You see that gold lead already dropped off behind the Alchemist because of the fact that they went and got that nice little pick there. And that puts us at 43 and 12, but that's about it. Beastmaster at 35, rolls on Ascario. Ascario's got nowhere to go. He's picked up, he's thrown down, and he is finished off by the rotating geniuses of Team Secret. Let's go to the net worth chart, because that's all that's going to matter here, Jun. Arrow is quickly dodged by everyone. Puppy wants to chase. He's got the boulder. I think he wants to just do it. Besides, it's just not worth it, as he saw that his Pilot Eye buddy was not coming along. Pilot Eye Smart has no escape, wanted to make sure he wasn't caught in an awkward position.
All right, Arteezy's gonna go. What a stack! What a stack for Arteezy. Oh, this is like death knells already. Ugh, look at this. Let's just watch the chart go up. Go in, they say, oh, look, they're in the Roach Pit. They're scouting around the stacks. Plenty. You'll notice that Bulbud never farmed out on that side. He just helped stack or let the stack stand. So that Arteezy could come out and get him whenever he wanted to. Bulbud from the backside gets the stun on Murs. Murs got nowhere to go. And once again, Massacre in the middle. EP still comes in. Dancer has his ultimate, so he wants to use it. Maybe a little too ballsy. Now they're going to get him. He's going to spin. Has enough for his ulti to come out of it. Now he has to back away. Yo doesn't even throw the arrow.
Mine.
Easy comes forward and just keeps on farming. He's got so many stacks to his name, so much gold just pouring in. He's already got 1,000 lead over the Juggernaut. Meanwhile, Bulba is actually about to pass the Juggernaut, and he's farming the old-fashioned way. Over the mid position, as Pylodai is taking over against Yo as they battle for mid dominance. Yo not rotating and ganking, surprisingly enough. That's sort of why you pick the Murana. You want her to move around and find things, but she's just not able to do that. Her arrows have not been accurate enough to catch Secret off guard. 5,000 gold lead already. XP at 3. Eternal Envy.
And the guys from Secret look like this one's borderline of the bag. Eternal Envy's got Armless and Mortigian already. He's got those going, and he's pretty happy about it, I would imagine.
And again, still stacking for TZ. So they're doing a good job of communicating and making sure that TZ gets whatever he needs to win this match. Pilot Eye, by the way, stole the arrow, so he's gonna be pretty happy about that. Now the question is, who hits more arrows, Rubick or Murana? And that's the potential to be very embarrassing. All right, arrow's gonna come out. Everyone rotates to top. This looks like the chance that maybe the Dire needs to stand up against Team Secret. Can they do it is the question. The answer is, I'm not really sure. They've got a tall order here. Bottom tower is gonna take some damage as Eternal Envy now comes back and defends it. So not much else beyond that. Scream trying to get some farm in the jungle. Murs in the mid position, happy to be left alone for once. Aladai is the last man holding in that top position. Here's the ping out by Envy saying, listen, he's got backup now. You guys can move on top. They left Juggernaut relatively alone. Brown can move in, but he's sort of out of position. There's Yo. Low on health. Only 640 health on Yo. Only 960 on the Juggernaut. And that's really what's making it difficult for them to engage in against these heroes. Uh-oh. Speaking of which, the arrow does catch Pilot Eye. There's the jump and the spin. So they get their first kill of the game. And now they're going to run. Bulba literally could not have timed that better. Holy crap. I'm sorry. Pierce is a magic community. Never mind. He's going to chase it down. Dancer ends up falling. Bulba gets the kill, and they kill a Juggernaut in exchange for a Rubick. Easy peasy, but that just shows you how slanted the game is right now, that it was almost an even gold change.
Dire's top tower is falling.
Let's go look in on bottom. Looks like Pilot Eye wants to mess with Murs. Steals the Forge Spirits, and now he's going to use Forges to push against the Forge Spirits.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Out, which my matriarch will prize. Haste!
Characters. Jeez. Oh!
He toggled it. He toggled the Sunstrike. What a dick. Wow. That was... Yes.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Toggled the Sunstrike. What a player. There's the yell on Cat Dancer. Bulba wants to keep fighting. Comes in. He's got the axes on standby. Healing Ward's going to come out. Can he finish the job? Dancer's got to run, but he's got no towers to retreat to. He has no hope. He's just slowed down. The boars are making him so slow. And he will slowly get away. The boars basically just eventually fell off because of the right click. Skewers to safety. Dodges the puppy boulder. Goalie at 7,500 XP at 6 right now, and Team Secret in a position to just once again dominate this match.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Sunstrike to follow. They got the combo, and Pilot Eye will go down for the second time in this game, but at what cost? Puppy comes in, gets up the magnetized. That's going to be a 1, and they go with Core for a support again. And Marana's forced to burn her ultimate. So they got the core of the support, burned an ulti. Playing a dangerous game following that Artesia round, sir. Jesus, 10,000. It's insanity. This just serves to show me how much Team Secret is better than I am. Regeneration. Or any human, for that matter. Oh my god. OG God's gonna have to take him on. Envy comes in with the blink stun, dick move, puts up the vision. Now he runs, but here's the trap. Uh-oh, Spaghetti-O. They rotated, they planned it, they baited you. Well played. And he stole Sunstrike. Rubik stole Sunstrike. What the? What? Oh my god. It's almost like this when you wish you had Odie Pixel stream, right? So that you could just listen to all the laughs that are going to be coming out. Because while that was happening, Juggernaut died top. It's crazy. This game, it's just dumb how good they are. It's just dumb. It actually makes me uncomfortable. Nice arrow, yo. Really wants to get that D ward. But it ultimately happens. Yo comes up, he wants to get out of there. Ascrino helps out. Pilot Eye has to back away. Still sitting on the Sunstrike. A while longer to enjoy it. Artesian. Pharmacy opponent's jungle. He's at 14. We're at 14,000 net worth. Artesian has more than doubled his opponents. This. Stun. Follow up. Sunstrike. My lord. Envy on the rotation, sees Dancer. Dancer wanted to ulti, couldn't get it off. The blink. Here's the dodge, the arrow missed. Oh my god. Oh no. They're following. They want him. He spins, good spin. Good necessary spin. We're on ulti. Good lord. It's just, what do you even do? I just feel bad.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Oh! Sunstrike goes in again. Dude, Pilot Eye is loving the Sunstrike. Loving it.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Oh, Mon up in the air, pulled back, knocked down, arrows everywhere. Yo!
gets swapped, but that's a death swap, and both go down. Arteezy gets a killing spree, Bulba gets a mega kill, and the towers and then the push are all but guaranteed. I've seen snowballs form. This goes beyond a snowball. This is downright impossible. We're hitting that point in the qualifiers where T's been playing for a while. Probably gonna start to see GGs come out a little earlier. The problem is that Secret is Secret, so no one's gonna GG early or aggressively early against them because they want a chance to really sort of test some skills one-on-one, see what they can do, and you know, it is what it is. So it looks like a Dancer maybe going for the Yasha? Started out looking at the Battle Fury, but so far hasn't really panned out for him. Arteezy will head back to the top lane. Roche goes down. Arteezy picks it up. Gold lead, by the way, for Arteezy is 18.4. That's his net worth right now. They've gone past 1,000 gold per minute on the opposing team. Envy picks off. Invoker got Slardar, so they actually made a play together. It was the Juggernaut caught Envy on the low ground, okay, and was able to get off, I think, a full duration Omni Slash. Yep. As well as a Sunstrike. So it was very effective and worked out for them. And that's a good kill. It's a valuable kill, but, you know, a little too late. Dire's top tower is under attack. Damn, Massacre. Let's go watch Arteezy take out the top tower all by himself.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
God, how do you stop? Arteezy's got the Radiance, the Bracers, the Manta, the Plate Mail. He's not that far from the AC. Bulma's got the Necro 3. Yo's got a run. Boulder up, one down. Did somebody order a double? Rubik's got his hands on the Blade Fury. Oh my god, Cat Dancer out of position. It's a helicopter war, folks. And he just gets caught out and destroyed. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, they're just gonna go push mid. The helicopter battle just fails miserably, and the actual spin to win loses his ass.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Arteezy gonna push up, wants to take some high ground. Why not? Why not just take it? God, this just kills left and right. Yeah. I mean, I think a lot of it, and Kojak brings it up in chat over on Twitch, the idea that playing against these teams has to be psychological. Like, they know they're going against Team Secret, and we're seeing that. We're seeing these teams play tentative. They don't want to be embarrassed. They don't want to put themselves out there and, you know, have Team Secret tell them that they did a bad job, and they don't want to be, they don't want to make the big mistakes because they know that they can't bounce back from them. Really, one of the things I think that makes you a great player is when you're willing to sort of take those risks. And that's why I do like Eternal Envy, is he puts himself out there. He's like, this may work. 60% chance, let's do it. And that's well above 60% as they go, oh my god. Oh no. The humanity of it all.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
GG, Jesus. 21 minutes. 30,000 gold net worth. 21 minutes. 30,000 gold net worth.
Dire's middle tower has fought Radiant victory.
Wow. Well, my name's Toffees, guys. Hope you enjoyed the cast. Follow me at Toffees TV. Wanted to make sure we had some English coverage here, so we're sticking around with Secrets since nobody else seems to want to be in lobby, which is strange to me. Everyone wants to cast from the ticket instead, but that means you can on Dota TV can't listen. So if you do appreciate